Hello everyone. So today we are going to learn the fourth topic, that is counter in a logic circuit. In this topic we are going to study about the basic content of the counter types: ripple counter, that is asynchronous one, then 4-bit up-down counter. At the last we study about the applications of counters. The counter is a digital sequential logic circuit in which a group of flip-flops are connected in cascade. The basic function of the counter is to count the input clock, that is to count the number of input clock pulse applied. The number of flip-flops used in the counter and the way in which these flip-flops are connected, which will determine the state and specify the sequence of that state at the each complete cycle. So next is the classification. It is of asynchronous and synchronous one. So let's see what is asynchronous and synchronous. Asynchronous counter. So this is, there is no clock to operate on the flip-flop, but here the first flip-flop will get the input clock pulse and the remaining flip-flop will not get the input clock, but whatever the external output of the first flip-flop is used as the clock for the next flip-flop. Okay, so this is also called as ripple counter. Why it is called ripple counter means the effect of an input clock pulse ripples through the counter flip-flop by flip-flop. That means if we have all the flip-flop with the clock, then the output is, there is no delay on the output side. It may be serial or it may be parallel. There is no delay. When we apply, go through the applying of the clock, the content will be going to shift by shift to get the output. But at the asynchronous one, there is a ripple. That means there is a propagation delay to reach the last flip-flop because of there is no clock. That is asynchronous one. Further propagation delay is true, FF1 to FF2, nothing but the flip-flop 1 to flip-flop 2 to be triggered because there is no apply of the clock. Therefore, the single clock pulse ripples through the counter flip-flop by flip-flop. So it will going to ripple. So that means the output of the first flip-flop is mainly on through the clock condition. For second, it is depend on the first flip-flop. For third, it depends on the second flip-flop. By this, it will going to ripple the clock pulse output at the last one. So next is the synchronous counter. Here the clock input is connected in parallel to all the flip-flop of the counter. That will, every flip-flop is clocked simultaneously at the same time. Thus, every flip-flop change its state at the same time in synchronous with the clock. So nothing but all the flip-flop consist of the clock to trigger the output, whatever it is stored. The examples of counter, it is the overall examples of the counter, that is ripple counter, decade, Johnson, ring counter, cascade, up down, synchronous binary, synchronous decade, and synchronous asynchronous binary counter. For your syllabus, you are having a ripple counter and up down counter. The first one is 4-bit asynchronous ripple counter. The name signifies that it is a asynchronous, there is no clock, but according to ripple we are going to apply the clock for the first flip-flop. So it consists of 4 master slave JK flip-flop. Nothing but the condition for JK flip-flop with a master slave condition, the input all 1-1, it will going to toggle, right? So toggle means if the output is 1, for the next it will 0, for next it is 1, for next it is 0, like this it will going to toggle. So that is, for both the input is high, nothing but for the master and slave JK flip-flop, both the inputs are high, then the output is toggle. Clear? So all the JK flip-flop inputs of 4 flip-flop are given to plus VCC. Why we have to give for plus VCC means the condition is we have to give toggle. Toggle means the input should be 1, right? So both the input should be 1, nothing but plus VCC, nothing but higher out voltage is going to apply for the JK flip-flop. It may be plus 5 volt or it may be higher one. So but at the same input is going to give for the JK. Each flip-flop is negative edge triggered. Next, the operation, how it is going to work is, since it is an asynchronous ripple counter, only the first flip-flop gets the clock input and the remaining one will going to wait for the output of the preceding flip-flop to change the state of the flip-flop. So this is the figure, that is a block diagram of a asynchronous binary ripple counter. So here we are going to use 4 JK master slave flip-flop. All input is applied with the plus VCC. The first flip-flop only have the clock and the remaining. So in the remaining is the output is given as a clock. Clear? So here the output is written as Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3. So this is how you are going to get the output. So first, this is the LSB and this is the MSB part. So let's see how it is going to work. So initially, before going to apply the voltage, the output is 0. Right, nothing but here is 0 0 0 0, so nothing but there is no content in the JK flip-flop. Clear? So when we apply the voltage, that is high, the J and K become 1. Right, for it is 1 1, the content should be toggle, so the content start with the 1. So the output is now changed to 1. Clear? So this is for first clock. For the next clock, for second clock, this one is changed to 0, but the previous output of the Q is 1. So here it is 1. The output of this will going to change this as 0 and this as 1. So here it is 1. For the clock 3, this one toggle to 1. Next one, it will toggle this one as 0 and here it is 0, like this. So like this it will going to toggle, that is it will going to change 0 and 1, 0 and 1, like this. So by this we get the output like this. The first is all zeros, so next is 1, so that is Q0, it will going to toggle. So next, second is this one is changed to 0 and this one is changed to 1. Clear? So next, here it is changed to toggle, then here it is changed to toggle, like this it will going to increase the toggling of the content from flip-flop to flip-flop. So this is about the ripple counter. So let's see what are the assumption we have made. So assumption is, we are using the content as all zeros initially with the 4 flip-flop to be reset to 0 output. The first clock apply, the first flip-flop will going to trigger, that is it will change 0 to 1. For second clock pulse, causes F0 toggles again and Q0 become 1 to 0. Then flip flop 1 will going to take the state to Q1 is equal to 1. Likewise, a subsequent clock pulse input ripples through the counter and the counter continues to generate the output up to all 1s and then recycle to 0. So this is about 4-bit asynchronous ripple counter. Next one is the synchronous counter, so that is 4-bit up down counter. So here we are going to get the counting from 0 to 15 or in the downward side 15 to 0. So if you want the up counting, the up counter or a condition control input is high. For down, you have to go for the low. So this is the figure for up down counter. So it looks difficult. Still, we have to explain the content of how it is going to be up and how it's going to be down for your purpose. So according to the content, I will go with the less, that is how it is to be done. So here we are going to use 4 JK master slave flip flop. We are going to apply high input clock to all the flip flop. Clear? So whatever the output we are going to get at each side, so that is go with the AND gate, and output of that AND gate given back to the OR. So this is how the circuit is. So by this it will going to give you up and down counters output. So this is enough for your content of the syllabus. For the up counter, it will start giving you 0000 up to 15. For down, so it is reverse, that is from 111 to 000. So this is about the up down counter with a 4-bit. So last one is applications of counters. The applications of counters is here we are going to use for the counting purpose. So it is used in digital clock, automobile parking control and parallel to serial data conversion. So this is about the counters. So this completes the counter topic. Thank you.